So you have your basic setup, your plastic instrument, your mixing pad, your tongue depressor, and cotton rolls to help retract and dry, okay? So I have my water. I'm gonna dispense my material first. Probably about a 1-inch strip. One equal parts, right? And I'm going to take those off that way they don't get contaminated. Now you can open your bags with your instruments and drop them on. You shouldn't touch the instruments with your bare hands. That way you can get rid of your trash, okay? Remember, your tray should look neat and organized. You don't want all that trash there. So I can just dump those on, get rid of my trash. Now I already did my morning wash, so I can just do a quick alcohol hand rub. If you need to adjust the chair at all, you can just use the foot control that way you don't get it. You really probably won't even need the light, but go ahead and rest your head right back. Does the headrest come to me for you? So you're going to go canine to canine. So I'm going to stick a couple cotton rolls in there. Just to help keep her dry, okay? I'll wait to torture her until she's got that mixed. All right, so I'm gonna mix. You just look like you're gonna drool on that much.
Oh,
I
thought you're, oh, God.
Yeah, okay.
The bottom definitely will, but.
Yeah, it'd be more likely to be a little more wet on the bottom, on the mandible, because of that salivary gland too behind the lower anterior teeth. So, if I were you, I would go with the maxillary arch. What do I know? So remember, you're just going to gather that up. On the tongue depressor, and we're going to put it into the water. And you flip that over, that way it doesn't stick to everything. Watch your hand. Is that a mirror so you can see?
No. Yeah, I think I can just sit it.
So you're going to roll it out.
Mm-hmm. concert instrument.
Get ready to grab a felt. So now I'm gonna go in there and trap. I'm just gonna put a cotton roll in there. Yep, there, okay. And then I'm gonna go with another one and just try her lightly. I'm gonna start from the central incisors, just knowing that the lip's gonna come down a little bit over here, so it's probably gonna keep pushing those away. So it's gonna be a little easier to work out that way. So you're gonna place one pellet in between each two. This is going to be a little more tricky on each other because you aren't post-surgical, okay? So a lot of you are not gonna have those open embrasures. I'm gonna go back and do that distal the canine after. Yeah, just because I know these are gonna start to slip off, if I don't, I'm gonna go across and put my strip there. Now, when you have a patient that's post-surgical, do you think they're gonna have a whole lot of saliva that's gonna be really wet there? No, because it's gonna be, it might be bleeding a little bit, but other than that, it's gonna be a little drier. So again, it's going to be easier on that post-surgical patient than it's going to be on. Now I'm going to remove that cotton roll and I'm going to start blending this a little bit because otherwise I'm going to lose it. Okay? It's going to start to slip. I'm just going to flush. And then I'm going to go in and work on that lingual after. So what you're going to do now is just retract her lip a little bit and go along and just try and blend those pellets with the strip that you put across. Now we know this is going to be tricky because you're not post-surgical. So what we're mostly looking for is to make sure you have a festooned appearance and it's not too bulky and it doesn't go all the way up into her vestibule, okay? Because if it went up all the way into the vestibule, it'd be uncomfortable. And you don't want it too thick that her lip would get caught up on it, okay? So that's mostly what we're looking for. You want it relatively thin, smooth, and we're gonna look for that festooning. So right here, you can see it comes down a little too low towards the distal of that canine. And it will come right off your teeth when you brush. actually, I'm gonna make your lives a little bit easier, and I'm just gonna have you do the facial. Because I just want to make sure, I just want to make sure that you get the concept of making sure it looks festooned, that it's thin and not too thick and not too close to the vestibule. Okay? So that should be like something what your finished product should look like. Okay? Not so terrible, right? Does it feel weird on the lip? It probably feels like your lip is sticking out to you.
It's not bad.
It's not so bad. So then when you go to remove it, you're just going to go to one end and kind of gently tease it off. This is a little more how it would come off, too, in the office. A lot easier than it did with Tyke Scott, right? And then if she does have any on her teeth, I can wipe some of it off with the cotton pellet. And then if there is any still stuck on, she'll brush with a toothbrush and it will come right off. Okay?